everyone. I'm Samantha, and today we're going to discuss what they got right with slime. This stuff should be illegal.
The history of this stuff will surprise you and delight. We're playing with slime on what they got right.
Slime is so trendy today. It's hard to believe that its origins can be traced back to an accident in World War II.
During the war, Japan blocked an important product from coming into the U.S., rubber. So when America tried inventing its own artificial rubber, one man accidentally created a gooey rubber that somehow could bounce. Although it didn't work as a rubber replacement, the mystery goop soon got a name, Silly Putty.
I can't help but wonder, what if World War II researchers were trying to make mini helicopters but ended up with fidget spinners?
After its introduction to the market in the 1940s, the stretchable goop took off in popularity. But originally, it wasn't marketed for kids. It was marketed to adults.
That's so ridiculous. Everyone knows Silly Putty is for kids. What's next? Shoe organizers marketed as toys for kids?
Check out my new shoe organizer.
Silly Putty isn't as goopy and stretchable as today's slime, but it marks the introduction for its very crucial ingredient, sodium borate. Now slime can be a solid and a liquid, scientifically known as non-Newtonian fluids. Under low pressure, such as dangling from above, slime stretches like a liquid. But under high pressure, it snaps, much like my abilities in the roller rink.
I'm smooth like liquid, until someone cuts me off and I break both legs.
Mattel introduced the first instance of slime in 1976. It was stretchier than Silly Putty before, bright green and stored in tiny little garbage cans.
In the mid-80s, slime was all over the place. GHOSTBUSTERS premiered in 1984 with a ghost that left slime all over Manhattan. Then Double Dare premiered on Nickelodeon in 1985 and dumped slime all over its contestants.
Its popularity spiked with Masters of the Universe. She-Ra's enemy Hordak would trap victims in his slime pit. It was an instant hit and spawned a craze. Slime mutated into different colors and remained a fun toy for decades, but it stayed out of the limelight. Until the internet.
Popular YouTube DIYers like Karina Garcia uploaded how-to videos, and soon kids everywhere were selling homemade slime.
With my recipe, I've personally been able to save up $4 for college. Slime is more than a formless gloopy blob. It's a popular toy, a stress reliever, and a money maker for kids who want to save up for college. Not bad for a botched experiment in World War II.